As a thrill engineer, I'm interested in the design of thrilling, highly emotive experiences.
Professor Brendan Walker and his team from top British universities have spent over a decade investigating how emotions can affect our bodies and looking for physical ways to measure them.
Part of my job is trying to work out why people are excited by something, why people are scared by things. We're developing a measure called the fear factor, which is going to enable us to assess different fearful situations.
For this experiment, Professor Walker has chosen a screening of Sinister, the new film from the makers of the horror classics Paranormal Activity and Insidious.
And because fear is such a strong emotional state, we can monitor it quite easily. The first thing Paul's going to fit you with are these heart rate sensors.
My cope with scares quite badly. I think I'll have quite a high fear factor.
Now, we know when you become scared, your heart rate goes up.
I'm not a big fan of horror films, but I've not seen many.
The second thing we're going to monitor is your skin sweat levels.
I'm quite a big fan of horror films. I do quite like them. They make you feel alive, I suppose.
Your body becomes clammy, you become a little bit sweaty, and we can monitor that using these two sensors.
With scares, generally, I'm OK, but on the odd occasion, I have hid.
And the final thing is your skin temperature. So as you become scared, blood draws away from the surface of your body, your skin temperature goes down.
I think my fear factor will be very high. Off the charts.
And all three of these sensors are going to be plugged into this medical monitoring device, which you're going to be wearing throughout the film. And by monitoring all three of those, this sort of triangulation of readings, we're going to be able to tell if there's lots of fluctuation in those, something's going to be incredibly fearful. It's the fear factor.
A full audience is on hand to help with the experiment. If your fellow filmgoers are being scared out of their wits, chances are it will increase the fear factor you yourself are feeling.
Good evening, everybody. Welcome to this special screening of Sinister. Tonight, we're going to be conducting an experiment into fear. So please sit back, try and relax if you're able, and enjoy the fear factor. Thank you. So when we look at a horror film like Sinister, it's going to be packed with all sorts of things which are going to make people scared. Looking at moments of anxiety, where you're building up to something but you're not too sure what's going to happen.
That's the family who lived here.
You think these are serial murders?
First one I found dates back to the 60s.
There are going to be moments of shock, where something jangles your nerves. And horror, looking at things to do with the supernatural, which we're all programmed to be quite scared about.
Professor Walker's new fear factor scale could be invaluable in trying to quantify exactly how terrifying an event actually is. But it'll also be interesting to see what kind of fear factor the different subjects register.
So, in trying to determine your individual fear factors, we've got some preliminary results from our data analysis. And I can reveal, Will, you experienced the least fear. With a resting heart rate of mid-60s, you got several peaks around 110. The second was Sam. Again, lowish skin sweat changes and temperature, but you had much more variation in your heart rate. Third place was Caroline. You came third, mainly because you had some incredibly high peaks, one of which reached 220, wow, near the end. So, who came first and second? This, for me, was a bit of a shocker. I have to say, the person who came second was Alice. There's loads of fluctuation in your sweat levels and your temperature, and you actually broke our heart rate monitor. It kind of went off the scale. We're trying to work out why that was, but you had an incredibly intense experience. So that brings us to first place. John, You were the highest fear factor out of everybody, and because your heart rate was so incredibly marked, you are the scaredest out of everybody.
Fear has always been with us, and it's an emotion we love to feel. Maybe because it's so primal, it makes us feel alive. Whatever it is, thanks to Professor Walker and his team, we finally have a way to measure man's deepest, darkest fears.